The statue of the Thousand Hand Bodhisattva is made of 30 kilograms of gold and decorated with more than 50,000 precious stones, including rubies, sapphires, and agates. It's valued at over 5 million yuan. It took Wang Shuwen nearly 10 years to complete.
我们这手做了十几遍，这个是日思夜想，这也可能是什么呀？有时候啊，会有一天呢，晚上，正在睡不着觉，忽然想起一个新的那个造型，包括他的手镯，手镯呢以前没有这么做过，都是啊就做一个圆的呀，镶上一点上一点翠，现在我们每只手镯。 都用红宝石、蓝宝石点缀上的，使得呢显得呢和整体非常协调。这样呢也使整个作品呢，除了外边玉石的白光之外，还有一道红光互相衬托着。它这20只手臂，那么没有显得很非常分散，而显得呢和整体造型呢合为一体。
In making the statue, Wang Shuwen used a special jewel setting technique called Hua Si, which dates back to the Shang Dynasty. Essentially, Hua Si involves using gold, silver, or copper to make a bed, into which the jewels and jade are set. In ancient times, the technique was used in making ornaments and works of art for the imperial family. The gold crown worn by Emperor Wan Li of the Ming Dynasty is a classic example of Hua Si.
It used 0.01 to 0.007 mm. The weight is very light, only 2 grams. On the head, 又华贵，又显示皇家气派。
Hua Si is a highly sophisticated technique. First, the gold and silver have to be drawn to form thin threads. Then the settings have to be prepared. Decorative patterns have to be carved on the threads, and the jewels, diamonds, and jade have to be put in place.
咱们画丝呢，开始呢，它是以丝为主，那么呢，丝呢，它要从粗要拔到细，那么就是每一道丝，通过这板眼，那么一道一道拔，那么从粗的丝，一直要拔到呢，32号，那么它就是按我们来说呢，它就是0.1。 到 0.15 丝，也就是说和我们头发丝粗细。
Once the threads are drawn to make the different sizes, they will be twisted together in pairs, rather like a rope. A more sophisticated technique involves weaving them to make a net.
这个是炮坯。 这个古代的炮坯呢，整个是拿这个丝，螺旋状的这个丝，原来呢是拿一个中间一根啊铁丝，很细的铁丝，把这丝啊卷起来，卷起来呢，然后两根丝用丝的套口来互相接，这需要很细心的、很耐心的。这个呢技术呢，就是手工来说是技术比较高的。 那么这个呢，就是咱们看看做那个皇冠，那就是先做成这样。它可以拉，然后套完了以后呢，它根据这个情况可以拉出各种形状。那么过去呢，像这个呢，它做出来好呢，再细的金的，那就可以披在身上。24开金的拉炮焊得了以后可以披着，它做的很短。 那就是显示着皇家贵族的气氛。
王树文 is one of only a few artists today who have mastered a special 花丝 setting technique.In the course of years of work and study, he has grasped many other skills, such as ivory and jade carving, which he incorporates in his creations. In 2000, president of the Hong Kong Jewelry Association, Wang Wanquan, approached Wang Shuwen with a particularly challenging commission.
黄先生给我提出说要做这天坛，这天坛那么多人来做，那么我要做也像他一样做，就是用黄金，就是用宝石，用钻石，也是一个堆出来的东西，没有什么新意感。那这个呢又给我提出了一个很高的难题。
Wang Shuwen was determined that his piece would break new ground. So, after talking it over with several experts, he decided on a bold new concept, a structure that could be opened. In the course of creating his masterpiece, Wang, with his traditional approach, had frequent arguments with Huang Wanquan, who favored a modern style of setting jewelry.The Temple of Heaven is nearing completion. Sadly, like so many other traditional handicrafts, the special huasi setting technique that Wang Shuwen cherishes is faced with extinction. But Wang Shuwen is working hard to try and save it. At the same time, he's also hoping to create a new wave of appreciation of other traditional handicrafts.